It's Barrage the Farage. You send the questions in. I don't see them before. Let's start with John. Nigel, assuming Boris Johnson will never bounce back, is there any Tory MP who you think would make a good PM? I think probably the most likely answer to that is it's somebody we haven't even thought of. It's very rarely the front runner that becomes the leader of the Conservative Party. Margaret Thatcher wasn't given a hope in 1975 and yet came through and won the election. And whether you agree with what she did or not, she would. Now, I think she was a strong leader. Kim, was she a strong leader?
I think she became the Prime Minister because she was strong. But I think Margaret Thatcher became a dictator, and that's what killed her.
Too long in power, probably.
Became a dictator.
Yep, too long in power. Yep, top job, 8 years, probably about right. Pauline asks, Nigel, do you go to the cinema much? And have you seen my latest 007 film? Do you know, I don't go a lot, but I do enjoy going to the cinema, and I want to go and see the 007 film. I've seen most of the previous ones at the cinema. Have you seen it?
I don't like Daniel Craig as James Bond.
Don't you? Are you a Sean Connery fan?
Well, no, but he's not like a James Bond, is he? I mean, I like Sean Connery, Roger Moore, Pierce Brosnan, but a little tiny chappy with a rather rough face, you see. And I'm being serious. He's only up to my ear, dear. And I think he's a good actor. He is not a James Bond fan.
Right, there we are. Alan on Twitter asks, why has it taken a tragedy like today to get the PM's attention focused on this? Look, he's been burying his head in the sand on this subject for the last 2 years. Occasionally, a journalist might ask a question about it and he brushes it aside. Perhaps it was always going to take a tragedy to get him to focus on it, which is a sad thing to say, but probably true.